Do, would you please welcome a man with an absolutely gorgeous voice, John Gorka.
Feel the wind blow. So then I know when to cruise our tainted life. I know that the church bells ring on the Sundays in this town, and I know songs from the first record that came out a few years ago. That last one was the title song, and both of those are kind of like a lot of the songs I do. They came from around the neighborhoods where I live. I've lived in Easton and Bethlehem, Pennsylvania for about the last 14 years, and thank you. In the eastern part of Pennsylvania, but originally I am from New Jersey. Thank you. So I wanted to let you know that right away. Some people like to hide that kind of fact. I once played at Passim in Harvard Square in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and somebody came up to me after the show, and I hadn't mentioned where I was from, and they said, "Are you from New Jersey?" And I said, "Yeah." "Does it show?" And she said, "Yeah." And she walked away. So for a couple years, I tried to figure out what that meant. I didn't really know it, and I think it has something to do with people from New Jersey tend to have a kind of a bad attitude about things. They tend to apologize for about being from New Jersey, and so I just wanted to let you know that I am from New Jersey, and I will always be from there. People like to move away and say that they're from somewhere else. Well, anyway, this is a song that tries to answer some of the questions that people have when they find out you're from New Jersey. It's called "I'm From New Jersey." I'm from New Jersey. Too much. If the world ended today, I would adjust. I'm from New Jersey. No, I don't talk that way. I watch too much TV when I was young. I'm from
Jersey who have that great big hair. They're found in shopping malls. I will take you there. There is no mystery, I can't pretend. I'm from New Jersey, it's like Ohio, but even more so, imagine that. I know which exit and where I'm bound. Tolls on the parkway, they will slow you down. New Jersey people, they will surprise you, 'cause they're not expected to do too much. They will try harder, they may go further, 'cause they never think that they are good enough. I'm from New Jersey, I don't expect too much. If the world ended today, I would adjust.
Thank you.
Full of disappointment. Yes, and I am full of life. Standing here without illusion. You know, I almost had a wife. It could be the path I've chosen. Just leaves no room for someone else. Or the woman who could stand me. Somewhere keeping to herself. Well, I can't say that I blame her. Right. When love is worse than being lonely, it leaves you twisted up inside. So on the outside you'll seem normal, but that only lasts a little while. No, I almost had. matter why. But life is full of disappointment. Yes, and I am full of lies. Life is full of disappointment. Yes, and I am full of lies.
Although this next song is the title song of the new record, that last one was kind of like the theme song, at least of the love songs on the record. The love songs aren't the most optimistic ones in the world. But it never seemed to me that when you're happy and in love, you should waste time writing songs. When you're brokenhearted, you have plenty of time. This is a song that came from a very troubled time in my life when I got a job. And it was a very scary time. I put it off as long as possible, at least a full-time job. When I got out of school, I had a part-time job delivering flowers for 3.5 years. I was able to get by, and I was amazed because I was able to, I really liked the schedule because I was able to sleep in the morning, and I worked a little bit in the afternoons, and I'd play at night, and sometimes I'd get paid, sometimes I wouldn't. And I was able to get by for a long time, but I wasn't able to put any money back into the music and buy things like picks, I guess, for... So I was offered this job and I took it, but it was a scary thing because I didn't know if I was going to have the time or the energy to do what I really wanted to do, which was write songs and sing them. So anyway, that's what's behind this song. It's called Land of the Bottom Line.
Steady dough, bouncing up my alley to the door. You fill your clothes with keys and responsibilities, trading maybe for the shore. Freedom for freedom, call that an even scheme. To be a kid and don't like work, but I don't like waste, and I don't like waiting for taste. Freedom for freedom, call that an even scheme.
Requests here.
I woke her up just before sunset. She slept. So that went to dinner, man. Bam. We got the 240 ferry.
At the sky like smoking guns, I learned to walk, I learned to run away. The day we met is still a blur, though I remember just how nice you were, what you wore in Central Park, and how you left before the darkness fell. Tracing back our history, it's a wonder how we came to be. Love driven through a dozen states, your technique for keeping me away. I'm better with each passing day. I guess you'll be the one who got away. Cause everyone has one of those. You wear them like you wear your clothes, except they don't come off at night. Are the space you hold up to the light? And somewhere along the line, you'll turn into a friend of mine. Of my unspoken cares amid the aftermath of love affairs. Still I cry over these strings, the sentimental case of things. I'm better with each passing day. I guess you'll be the one who got away. Now I stand beneath these trees, not far from the refineries, aimed at the sky like a smoking gun. I'll learn to walk, I'll learn to run again.
Thank you. This is a song about groundhogs. I know this is a zoo. This is not exactly a zoo kind of animal song, but it is about groundhogs. Some places are known as woodchucks and whistle pigs in other places. That's my favorite name. Well, in the part of Pennsylvania I live, when I moved from New Jersey, I started to notice that there were a lot of them, and a lot of them built their homes on the sides of the roads, and they used the paved part of the road as their patios. And they tend to lounge out there on their patios when the weather started to get warm. And some of them didn't end up in the greatest shape, and I came to believe they were the thrill seekers of the animal kingdom. It's about one groundhog in particular by the name of Lowell. It's called Springtime in Pennsylvania.
Four stiff legs pointed to the sky. Child, his eyesight was bad, and he face of a worm that he already ate. While the round little load on the shoulder of the road, where the grass is being mowed, he is reaping what he sowed. And it's a warm day. Springtime has sprung once again in Pennsylvania. Why he chased the bus, why he did not leave the driving to us. Was he tired of his hole, looking for a fishing pole? They say his name was Lowell, till the tire freed his soul this morning. He liked Elvis, he liked Bing, and he smiled at the girls, though his lip was always curled. Now he's in another world as of this morning.
Thank you. This is a song from just a couple months ago. It's kind of about the neighborhood I live, where I live, in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. When I say Bethlehem, I'm not talking about the Holy Land. There's no mangers there. And absolutely no wise men. It's kind of urban, but it's not that far from country kind of stuff too. It's a pretty nice place to live. I've been around there long enough so that I could see the area change a little bit, and I think that's what this song's about. It's called Where the Bottles Break.
Still comes back. I live where the neighbors yell and their music comes up to the floor. I live where the neighbors yell and their music wakes me up. Life beyond the playground fence, serious as basketball. Life beyond the playground fence, serious. Oh, live. Buyers come from somewhere else. They raise the rent so you can't hide. The buyers come from out of state. They raise the rent. Buy low, sell high. You get rich and you still die. Money talks.
From the new record, came out in May, and it's still out. I'm real glad about that. This is the only boxing song on the record. I lived for a long time in Easton, Pennsylvania, which is just one town over from Bethlehem. And Easton's most famous resident is a guy named Larry Holmes, the former heavyweight champion boxer. It's also the home of Crayola Crayons. Thank you. And Silly Putty. So there's a lot of culture in the area, and I soaked up as much as I could while I was there. This is a song about people who make a living hitting people in the head. And getting hit in the head. Even the best of them seem to end up at a place I call Dream Street. I saw the champ running down by the river with his trainer and his stretch limousine. But it was late in his career when he was featured in those Glove magazines. Never leave the ring before it's too late. Never seem to quit in their prime. I guess you take him as a given that a champion is driven so he could always win one more time. There's an
new reservation on Dream Street. For a room with no view of before, it takes years for some to check in, but Dream Street will beckon till they're mumbling their names at the door. Some do it out of pride, some do it for the dope, some do cause it's the only thing they're ever gonna know. Promoters take the money, fighters take the pain, they find a new sucker, they do it again. Take it away. So there's a new reservation on Dream Street. For a room with no view of before. It takes years for some to check in. But Dream Street will beckon till they're mumbling their names at the door. Dream Street is calling, yo. Dream Street is calling. Dream Street is calling. Dream Street is calling. Thank you. and the stars will fall around us still. While the love is realizing, so it is until we meet again. Throw my arms around you. You can count the gray hairs in my head. I'll still be thankful that I found you. It's from me, it's to you. For your eyes, it's a way. Wonder that is why I am here, you are there. Love is our cross to bear. Love is our cross.
Thank you. This one is a more recent song. It seemed like last fall a lot of my friends were going through really difficult times that they didn't seem to deserve, so I decided I'd write a song and put them in there, let them know I was thinking about them. It was also inspired by a song I heard on the radio. It's kind of like a rock and roll song, and the rock and roll guy was kind of complaining about this woman who had broken his heart, and he said he couldn't understand. Couldn't understand why she had broken his heart, because he had gone out of his way for her. And she still broke his heart. So by the end of the song, I realized the woman had done the right thing. And I probably would have rather heard her song. So this, at least the beginning of this is kind of a reaction to that. It's called Treasure Island.
Oh, love is never easy. It's almost always out of your way. It's not the path of least resistance. It's not some words you get to say. Running up the mountain,
kind of a fictional song. It's based on a couple of songs B.B. King made famous. One is his signature tune, The Thrill Is Gone. The other one isn't quite as well known. It's called Nobody Ever Loved Me But My Mother. And she may be jiving too. It's called B.B. King Was Wrong. This next one is my mother's favorite song, and it's the only one that she ever requests. It's actually the result of listening to too much country music. I found out recently country music is like cholesterol. And there's good country music and there's bad country music. And the bad country music can be hazardous to your health. Especially if you're a songwriter, I found. I fell asleep listening to this terrible country music radio station out of Allentown, Pennsylvania, that played the worst in country music without commercial interruption. I fell asleep listening to this station, and I woke up the next day, and the song was in the room. And I was alone. Goes like this.
I asked my baby to come into my kitchen so we could try on a brand new recipe. All she said was that she wasn't hungry. Things smell bad for me. And the pilot light is out. a sing-along, by the way. Oh, I can hear that train whistle blowing. You'd have taken us on a shopping spree. Now, like me both in this house, I'm left over. Fast limit and that fast food misery. Rack would have saved us. Likewise, the brand new Tupperware. But the perfect match is damp. Push has come to shove, and the pilot light is out on our rubber of love. Now the tragic conclusion. Home of perfume on her pillow still lingers. Though her eyes held no love at last sight, she said she was leaving for health reasons. Cause I made her lose her appetite. Life used to be a gas lamp, burning free. It's time to end up with us. I guess it's time for that easy out, love and cleaning. You tried to hug, try to ease her off my memory. You're on your own now. And the pilot light is out. And the pilot light is out on our own.
Glad we did.
Love.
Thank you. I have no idea what time it is, so I'm just gonna keep playing. I'll keep playing until you say stop. This is a song about my home, in my old home, about my own ex-roommate there in Easton, Pennsylvania. My roommate was, and it's still, oh, he's not my roommate anymore, but he used to be, and he's, wait a minute, excuse me. One of the main reasons I started writing songs is because I couldn't talk right. Anyway, this is about my ex-roommate who plays in a blues band in the area, Eastern Pennsylvania. He's starting to get around. He's gotten really good over the years. For a long time, though, he wasn't just into the music, but he was also into the lifestyle of the blues, and he would live out the lyrics of the songs that he would play. So I started writing down some of the things he'd do, and they turned into songs again. Late last year, though, he fell in love with someone who fell in love with him. And they got married, and they have a small child. And I was evicted from this place, which really doesn't exist anymore, because this is, we used to call it the Blues Palace. And that's the name of the song, too. It's this Blues Palace. Natural song. for a natural kind of a place. This is a song about wanting to be a tree when you grow up. And, this is a movie that could have inspired the song had I seen the movie before I wrote the song. But I didn't. Although it was made before I wrote the song. Stars Jason Robards as a mailman who doesn't want to be a mailman anymore. He decides he'd rather be a tree. So he goes in his backyard and he digs a hole. And he stands in it every day instead of going to the post office. And the people at the post office start to worry about him, and his wife starts to worry about him. I don't want to spoil the ending for you or anything. The name of the movie is called Mr. Sycamore. You may want to see it sometime. And the name of the song is Branching Out.
Put my feet in the ground, take the winters off, settle down, keep my clothes till they turn brown. When I grow up, I'm gonna settle down.
Song from the series of songs of love, nutrition, and barnyard animals. This one is about pigs. It's called Prom Night in Pigtown.
There were ham bones in long gowns with painted cloven hooves. There was no need for shoes for the curlers in their tails.
I got a request for a song I don't know. So I'd like to do this one instead. A song I do know. This is moving from the natural kind of songs to this is sort of on the supernatural. I think it's kind of scares me a little bit. The best way I can describe it is kind of like Edgar Allan Poe and Leonard Cohen meet the Wolfman. It's called Raven in the Storm. Next to last thing is actually a medley of two songs. Most medleys are longer than that, but this one isn't. The first part of the medley was inspired by my feet. And the second part of the medley was inspired by the 1988 elections. This is called the Body Parts Medley. I like my feet. They're very neat. None can compete with the meat in my feet. I like
around for laughs. Both of my hands take their baths with my cat. I like my thighs, they're just the right size. They help me rise to new heights, my two thighs. Oh, it's nothing but a butt. It's nothing but a big butt. It's beefy and mean, Boston baked bean, burnt burrito and a beer butt. It's a really, really big butt. It's nothing but a bug. So what the heck was that? But it's really, really lean. Hardly nothing in between. Trendy out to make the scene. But it's a hardly nothing there. But it's an absent derriere. But it's really, really lean. Hardly nothing in between. Trendy out to make the scene. But some butts are lost in poker games. Some butts end up in slings. Some butts end up as presidents who wish they could be kings. There's nothing but a butt. Double burger on a bun. But they're burly and bold. Don't you worry about the cold. Yes, they got an extra. It's a really, really big butt. It's a really, really big butt. It's beefy and mean, Boston baked bean, a burrito and a beer butt. It's really, really lean, hardly nothing in between. Trendy out to make the scene, but.
Thank you. I can't believe some of the songs I come up with. I was riding on a train when that song came to me, and I said, oh no, I can't believe this. But these songs cry out to be written. At least to me. Thanks a whole lot for coming out and sitting and listening, and I hope I can come back sometime. I'm going to be coming back to Seattle in October. I think I'm playing at the Backstage. Come there. I've got two records out. The first one is maybe a little bit hard to find. It's called I Know on Red House Records, and the new one is on Windham Hill, and it's much easier to find. If you buy the new one, you can actually get the address of the and the phone number of the record company that has the first one. But I'm glad it's out there, and I'm glad you're out there too, and I don't know where you came from, but I'm glad you're there. Thank you.
took me by surprise.
Thank you.
Behind, and that would be wonderful if we could keep that straight record going. Don't forget, John Stewart is here for the Concert for Wildlife this Saturday. That show is at 6:30, and it will be right here. And on behalf of the JCs, Natural Selection, and City University, we want to thank you all for coming. Thanks for listening to 98.9 FM. We'll see you here next year.